We want to evaluate the logarithms given natural log x equals 3, natural log y equals 4, and natural log z equals 5. So to evaluate these, we'll expand these logarithms as much as possible using the properties of logarithms, and then perform substitution for natural log x, natural log y, and natural log z. So looking at the first logarithm, notice how we have natural log of a quotient, and since we have the natural log of a quotient, we can expand this to the difference of two logarithms using the quotient property given here, where we'll have the log of the numerator minus the log of the denominator. So this is equal to natural log x cubed minus, because of the quotient, natural log y squared z. Now looking at the second log, notice how we have natural log of a product, which we can expand using the product property of logarithms given here, where log x times y is equal to log x plus log y. We have to be careful here because if we're subtracting this second logarithm, we'll have to subtract the expansion or the sum of the logarithms. So this is equal to natural log x cubed and then minus the sum of the two logs, which would be natural log y squared plus natural log z. If we leave off these brackets, notice how we'd only be subtracting the first logarithm, which would be incorrect. And now for the next step, we're going to apply the power property of logarithms given here, where we can take the exponent here and here and move it to the front. So now we would have 3 natural log x minus 2 natural log y and plus natural log z. Notice in this form, we can now substitute for natural log x, natural log y, and natural log z. If we wanted to, we could clear these brackets by distributing negative 1, but let's go ahead and leave it in this form. So we'd have 3 times natural log x, which is equal to 3, minus, and then in brackets, the quantity 2 times natural log y, where natural log y is 4, plus natural log z, which is 5. So this would be 9 minus, this would be 8 plus 5, or 13. So 9 minus 13 is equal to negative 4. Okay, let's take a look at our second example. The first thing we should do here is write the square root using a rational exponent. If we have the square root of a, because it's a square root, the index would be 2, the exponent would be 1, this is equal to a to the 1/2 power, which means you can write this as natural log x squared y to the third z to the fifth to the 1/2 power. And in this form, we have powers raised to powers. So if we have a to the m raised to the power of n, the rule is that we multiply the exponents. So let's go ahead and do that. This is equal to natural log 2 times 1/2 would be 1, so just x to the first, y to the 3 times 1/2, or y to the 3/2 power, and then z to the 5 times 1/2 would be z to the 5/2 power. And now we can expand this. Notice how we have a product. Therefore, we can write this as a sum of not only 2 logs, but 3 logs involving x, y, and z. So this is equal to natural log x plus natural log y to the 3/2 plus natural log z to the 5/2. And then finally, we can apply the power property of logarithms, which means we can take the exponent here and here and move it to the front, so it's the coefficient. So now we have natural log x plus 3/2 natural log y and plus 5/2 natural log z. And now we can perform substitution once again for natural log x, natural log y, and natural log z. Natural log x is equal to 3 plus 3 halves times natural log y, which is 4, which I'll write as 4 over 1, plus 5 halves times natural log z, where natural log z is equal to 5, which I'll write as 5 over 1. Notice how this product here will simplify. There's 1 factor of 2 and 2, and 2 factors of 2 and 4. Nothing simplifies here. So we have 3 plus, this would be 6, plus this would be 25 halves, or 12.5. So 3 plus 6 is 9, and 9 is equal to 18 halves. 18 halves plus 25 halves is equal to what? 43 halves. Or if we want, 21.5. That's going to do it for these two examples. I hope you found this helpful.